Yemma has cleared the air about Sinaye because I know it has been on so many persons' mind, like, what is going on between Yemma and Liam? What is going on between Sinaye and Liam? Like, the siblingship, has it ended? What's going on? But Yemma has answered those questions, and answers she shared on her Instagram story, like she put up this just like Sinaye did one time, just ask me anything, let's interact. You want to spice up the lovely one? Make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel if you have not subscribed, guys, and please don't forget to like the video and share if you can. Yeah, so earlier today in my last upload, I had shown you guys the life they had, because previously Sinaye was asked if he was going to move to Johannesburg. He said yes, definitely he has gotten a place of his own. So you can see the way the housemates are interacting. So meanwhile, Lily was asked, okay, less and less of questions. I think it has to do with the challenge about Sinaye. So just stick, watch the end of the video, okay? I'll be taking you guys through all her responses, her constructive responses to lots of questions that were put out, okay? So, she was asked about the Mpumele law, okay? And you know, she's so thankful to CC Worldwide for that. And, you know, saying she also misses her fans too. When they say, like, oh, they miss her. Like, okay, the stress, but she's tired. Like, some of her fans are asking that she should, you know, make a video and send to them. Okay. And she had revealed that since she left Big Brother's house, it has not really been easy. She's been booked, she's been busy. Okay, so the fans went ahead to ask her, you know, or to tell her, we want to see you in this country, we want to see you in that country. When are you coming to Durban, July? When are you coming to Botswana? When are you coming to Nigeria? When are you coming to Ghana? And her response is, book me a flight and I will be there. Honestly, guys, her responses to all the questions that she was asked were top notch. And when she was asked about Sinaye, she said, that's my person for life. Like, that was not the only place she mentioned. She talked about Sinaye. She said Sinaye is her person for life. So for those of them thinking that, oh, the siblingship has ended because Liema supported Mark Jr., this, that, is that. So I think both of them know what they are doing. They may not come open to tell you guys that we are cool, but really, they are. Okay, so they kept on asking her. She said, I'm not really materialistic, but I think I love shoes, shiny shoes. She said she's not a materialistic person, but you know, she loves, of course, we can see it in most of her dressing, that she loves shoes a whole lot, guys. A whole lot. Okay, then how was your working with CC? Honestly, she said CC is like a role model. Guys, we can attest to that. CC is like a role model to Liam Apansi. Like, it's just like someone who helps you achieve your dream. It's like a dream come true for her. And you know, she had mentioned there are some other persons she may want to work with, like Tyler and the rest of them. So when one of the fans asked her if she was going to continue with her studies, she said definitely she was going to continue with her studies, because in as much as they are pursuing their passion, their career, you don't have to do away with your education. Just recently, young papi graduated, okay, though fans are bashing him that it's just diploma, but at least it's something. And Kosi also graduated. They say she has 3 degrees from 3 different schools, and I think she has bagged a master's. So guys, it's worth it. So Liema said, yeah, definitely she is going to go back to school. So like, her responses were so constructive. And when they asked her, where would you want to like do your, she said overseas is her dream. Like, that is definitely where she wants to go, overseas. Okay, and you guys know that her previous Instagram account, or was it Twitter, is a paradise. That was a lemma we know, that's always on braids, that's always on locks. And you know, some of our fans are trying to say we love that paradise. I hope we're going to be seeing it. She said, yeah, definitely you are going to be seeing it. But guess what, guys? I think Erica, if you know Erica from BB Niger, I can't remember the season, Erica and Leredim, you know, is following her. And oh, if I lost us, Liam McCray started following her. So people like, are you aware that Erica is following you? Oh, Liam was like, yeah, that she really cried when Erica left the house. You guys remember Erica was disqualified, that she's a very big fan of Erica and Leredim. And a fan of her went ahead to ask if she has met Mercy Eke, or when is she going to meet Mercy Eke. And she said, I read Mercy Eke, she can't wait. Guys, and Mercy Eke replied and said, I can't wait to give you a hug, Osisi. Like, it was really so fun. The question section was, and her answers were really constructive answers. I loved the fact that she answered each and every question with, like, intellectually. It was not, she was brief. She just hits the nail on the head. She wasn't really going all beating about the bush. She was just nailing the head at the point and giving every response that was needed intelligently. Seriously, guys, I have to tell you guys, okay? She revealed the ones that she feels needed to be revealed, and she kept the ones that she felt the needed to, okay, be kept. Like, some questions I would, as she said, I would do what I would reveal soon. So guys, it was really a beautiful question and answer section. Okay, the housemate had, some of the fans had thrown the questions at her, and she kept answering the question. The last time it was Sinaye that did such, okay, on his live, and the housemates had agreed to, sorry, his fans, guys, had agreed to ask him diverse questions, which they were expecting responses, and they actually got the answers to their questions. So this was exactly what, it's just a kind of like get to know me more, okay, a kind of way of interacting. But she has attested that it's not easy post show, because one of the fans had to ask, what advice would you give somebody who want to go into the Big Brother house? He said, just be yourself and just make sure that you're emotionally strong to like take up whatever thing you see in the house, and make sure you're going there to like you have something you can fall back on post show. Guys, it was really an amazing time. It was really a beautiful question, and people got beautiful answers, and I believe the fans were really satisfied. So, but some of the key points you could take from here is that Liema and her brother Sinaye are cool. I don't think they have issues. If one of the fans had to put up, they are still waiting for Sinaye for his Umphumelelo challenge, and Sinaye had to repost that thing on his story too. So literally, they are okay. There is no problem. It's just that some fans are being so fast, trying to dig. I know it may hurt him, being that this is a sister that I really appreciate so much and I really like so much. You know, Liema throwing the dagger at Meg Junior and saying she wants all the things to be focused. I know it really got to Sinaye, but definitely they are going to like get over it and talk things over and reconcile. So you guys, that's all for that. Let me know what you guys feel. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.